If I'm given a square matrix A, an eigenvector associated with that matrix is a vector so that when I multiply the vector by A, the effect of multiplication is a scaling of that eigenvector, and the scaling value is called the eigenvalue. So I'm given a square matrix A, an eigenvector, we'll call it V, associated with that matrix is a vector so that when I multiply on the left by the matrix A, the effect of that multiplication is a scaling of the eigenvector by this value lambda, which is the eigenvalue associated with that eigenvector. So one more time, core idea behind eigenvalues and eigenvectors is given a matrix A, a square matrix, an eigenvector associated with that matrix is a vector such that when I multiply by A on the left, the effect of the multiplication is a scaling of the vector by its corresponding eigenvalue. The eigenvector V, by definition, is not the zero. Let's suppose we have a nice matrix, make things small in dimension here, let's say 3, 1, 1, 3. Okay. Now I want to take that matrix and we'll define a vector. This will turn out to be an eigenvector, as we'll see in just a moment. Let's say a vector 1, 1. So what is the result of multiplication here? A on the left times V, okay? So I multiply the matrix 3, 1, 1, 3 times the vector 1, 1. Notice this matrix multiplication is defined. Again, a vector can be considered as something of a degenerate or one-dimensional matrix. So when I perform the matrix multiplication, the dot product here, 3, 1 dotted with 1, 1 results in 4, 1, 3 similarly dotted with 1, 1 results in 4. So what do we have here? We have AV, my matrix times this vector. Well, the action of that multiplication in a geometric sense is a scaling of the original vector V by value 4. So AV, in other words, here is equal to lambda, where lambda is 4, my scaling factor, times the original matrix. So the bottom line is, to be an eigenvector, when I multiply on the left by my matrix, the action of this multiplication results in a scaling of my eigenvector, in this case by the value 4. I'd like to shed a little more light on this idea of eigenvalues and eigenvectors now from a geometric perspective. So we'll continue with the example where we call the matrix A, this 2x2 matrix 3, 1, 1, 3. And as you'll recall from the earlier example, one of the eigenvectors associated with that matrix, we'll call that vector V1, is the vector 1, 1. So I've drawn that now in the plane. And then the resultant action of multiplying the vector V1 on the left by the matrix aforementioned A here was this kind of stretching or scaling by a factor 4. Again, that was the lambda associated with that eigenvector. So we can think of this geometrically here. AV1 results in what? Results in 4 times V1. Okay, so there's a nice kind of geometric rendering of what it means to be an eigenvalue and an eigenvector for a matrix. As I also said earlier, this particular matrix, as is common with lots of matrices, has other eigenvectors associated with it. And I'll show you how to compute some of those things in just a moment here. But one of the other eigenvectors associated with that particular matrix, we'll call that vector V2, is the vector, as I've drawn here, negative 1, 1. And the eigenvalue associated with that particular eigenvector is the value 2. So in other words, lambda is 2 for this particular eigenvector. So the result then of multiplying, let's say, the vector V2 on the left by the matrix A is that I get this scaled version, twice times the original vector here.